History shows when disaster strikes, Americans do respond.
But is there a right or wrong way to open your wallet? WGN's Julie Unruh is here to tell us.
It's a question that we pose to the pros. They know a whole lot more about this than we do, because from devastating hurricanes to deadly mass shootings, with hardly any time to process it all, America's still in shock from one horrific incident when another one strikes. One consultant in the philanthropy world gives us some ideas on how to be ready to help.
Let's write that check. Let's send that money. When the fifth or sixth one hits, it's like, oh my gosh, you know, are they ever going to stop? And does my donation make a difference?
This philanthropy advisor says, yes, it does make a difference. But for the big-hearted, being prepared financially in advance is the first right step. Lisa Dietlin suggests you have three categories of giving always at the ready. Most people like to give to a house of worship, their alma mater, or their kid's school. Then, she says, pick a third charity or organization that means something to you for one reason or another. Then add one more step.
And then set aside a little bit of money for these unanticipated disasters or opportunities that come along that could help you do better with your philanthropy.
She says decide if you want to give locally or globally by really listening to your head and your heart.
Do you want to lift people up, or do you want to eradicate something?
Is education or the arts your thing? Maybe you want to help find a cure for cancer or put an end to poverty. But as far as what to give during major disasters, natural or otherwise?
If you want to give things, give it locally. If you want to give to the bigger disasters that are happening, again, making a financial contribution is the better option.
Dietlin can't say it enough. She recently got a call from music sensation Bruno Mars.
Lisa, I have 5 semi-trucks of water. They're in L.A. How do I get them to Miami to get them to Puerto Rico?
Then another call from comedian Adam Sandler.
Hey, my friend has 12 satellite phones, and we're trying to get them into Puerto Rico.
Big stars with big hearts are the best clients to have, Lisa says. She's lucky that way, but their generosity isn't always wrapped in a pretty package with a nice, neat bow as crisis consumes an afflicted region.
If high-profile personalities who have access to everything can't get product into country or into the island or into the affected areas, many viewers would be thinking, how can I do that? That old saying, cash is king, is true.
We are all here to help.
That is why Mark Anthony and his ex, Jennifer Lopez, collaborated just this weekend to raise over $35 million for victims of recent natural disasters affecting Mexico, Puerto Rico, and the Caribbean in their benefit concert called Somos Una Voz. Any one of these tragedies staggering in their own right. Together, willing donors might be left to choose between them. Dietlin frequently encourages the generous to do just that. Give more money to fewer causes and have a greater impact.
Most people want to know that they've made a difference. When their head hits the pillow at the end of the day, they want to go to sleep knowing that they helped somebody.